John, this is a fight that you've been calling for even before you were in the UFC, right? Like, I mean, I can remember that whole first movement with the son and everything like that. You were pushing out these articles. It wasn't the first fight you got, but it's coming now. Like, are you still as passionate about this matchup as you were initially?
Yeah, 100%, and it's even more added on to it now, you know. But this fight should have been my debut. You know, I asked for this fight. It would have been great to have this as my debut. It didn't work out, and obviously we've tried to get the fight on before. We were both in the UFC. It never happened. So it's better late than never. It sucks, really, that we both coming on losses. Jack are on losses, I'm on losses, and possibly the loser leaves UFC. So that really sucks, but it's a fight that the Welsh public want to see, and I think it should happen because it's the unofficial title of Wales. Whoever wins this out of me and Jack is the king of Wales. We're proven the best middleweight to come out of Wales.
Oh, absolutely. I couldn't agree more. And there's obviously like the former Bama champion, former Cage Warriors champion. Is this something that a lot of people are talking about in Wales? Because I know MMA is absolutely crazy over there at the moment.
Wales is going crazy with it. I think the last person in Wales is going to turn the lights off. They're all coming to London this weekend. Don't worry about that. And we've got the Grand Slam, you know. So, yeah, it's going to be a good weekend for Welsh sport.
You know, having been in there twice, John, and I know you wanted to get off to a big start. You're known for that explosive knockout power. We all know about that in the UK and Ireland. I mean, do you feel like having been in there, that's going to stand to you this time around? You know what it's like. You've been there. You've put it on the shorts. You've made your entrances.
100%. The first time, the pressure, you know, it was just overwhelming. Not sort of the pressure, but just the occasion of everything, you know. And
counting down for so many years, I imagine.
Yeah. I'm going in. I just went in with the wrong frame of mind, you know, being too nice, you know, not the usual killer, and that will show in this fight, you know. And I can make excuses for the second fight. I had 21 days notice, fucking 2 weeks of training. I couldn't do a round on a bag, you know. It's a miracle I went out of that far, to be honest. But I needed the money, I needed the fight. I'd like to get that fight on where we both have a full camp each after this fight.
Do you tap into something more raw for this? Like you said, you kind of had to find that kind of killer instinct. You were a bit too happy. Did you find yourself kind of tap into a more aggressive vein in yourself?
Yeah, I think, you know, certain fighters fight with emotion. Certain fighters don't. With me, I fight with emotion. You know, I've got to put in my head that this guy is my enemy. He's not my friend. He's come here to hurt me. He's come here to take food off my plate. You know, it's kill him or he's going to kill me. And I always need to have that. I didn't have that in my first fight. It was like, it threw me off, you know. It was like, oh, we've made the big stage and Charles come over, hey, we're going to have a great fight. And I was like, normally it was, fuck off, I'm going to kill you. And it was like, oh, yeah, right, you're going to go a good fight. And it threw me off. It was too nice. And I was like, but there you are. It's going to be, I'm going to kill this fight now.
Do you feel like that? Do you feel like we're going to see one of these vintage John Phillips knockouts on Saturday night?
I think, to be honest, I've had a year of frustration built up, and the knockout is coming, it's regardless, you know. But even if I have the best knockout of my career, I won't celebrate the victory. You know, I won't celebrate beating Jack, a fellow countryman. We're both champions in my eyes, and you know, whether he beats me or I beat him, and one of us actually has to leave UFC, I couldn't celebrate that. You know,
do you feel that is on the line for both of you guys here? Because the middleweight division, like, I mean, there isn't as many bodies. Like, obviously, you guys are big draws over here. Do you feel like it's a dead cert if someone loses here?
I don't know. You know, I may be jumping to conclusions. We may have fight tonight and they could keep us in. I don't know. But, you know, it's not good, is it? You know, especially if Jack has four losses, we have three losses in a bounce. It's definitely not good. But, you know, people don't see things happening behind the scene and circumstances and, you know.
And congratulations on the business, Hemp Heroes. It's doing great. I need to get some for my dog, right? Because I see so many dogs on the Instagram page, right? It's good for dogs, right?
That's awesome, man. It's awesome. And thanks for the plug. It's great. It's fantastic.
I need it for my cockapoo. He's too active. I think this might chill him out.
See you later, right?
But it's going well. You seem to be branching out.
It's going really good. We're not making any money off it yet. Everything goes back in. But it's growing. It's growing nice, you know. And it's the maddest story. If they don't know the story, how it saved my dog and then it branched into a business. It's crazy how things turn around, you know.